वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लासेस ऑफ बी फार्मा थर्ड सेमेस्टर. दिस इज रोहित कुमार त्रिवेदी. ओके, वी आर डिस्कसिंग द फार्मास्यूटिकल इंजीनियरिंग, द वेरी फर्स्ट यूनिट, द इक्विपमेंट दैट आर यूज फॉर द प्रोसेस ऑफ साइज रिडक्शन. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फ्लूड एनर्जी मिल. प्रीवियसली वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बॉल मिल. ओके, यू कैन गेट दोज वीडियोज इजिली. Okay, on my YouTube channel. You can also follow and subscribe my YouTube channel. You can also follow me on Facebook. Okay, there is a Facebook page with the name Rohit Kumar Trivedi. You can like that for getting the latest pharmaceutical engineering notification and the video lectures on it. And you can also share all those things with your classmates also. Okay, now let's start. Fluid energy mill. Okay, the very first thing that we will discuss the principle behind the working of the fluid energy mill. The principle of the fluid energy mill is impact and attrition. Okay, maybe in examination there will be a question, write about the size reduction mill that works on the principle of impact and attrition. You can simply write about the fluid energy mill that is used for size reduction. It works on the principle of impact and attrition both. Okay, we have already discussed what is impact and what is attrition in my previous videos. You can get those videos very easily on YouTube. Now, it is a typical structure, laboratory structure of the ball mill. In industry, the structure may vary, but basic principle and the working will remain same. Okay, now moving further, now see what exactly happens in a fluid energy mill. It has a very simple structure. Okay, there is a tube like structure, open tube structure. There is a inlet using which the solid material is gets entry inside the mill. Okay, and the very bottom of this machine, you can see there is a opening. Okay, basically these opening are for the high speed air or the compressed air, we can say. Okay, high speed air. This high speed air is responsible for the size reduction and the separation inside the fluid energy mill. Okay, now let's see what happens. And again, there is a one more important part. Okay, this is called a collector or classifier. Means the small or reduced particles are collected in this classifier and removed out of the machine. Okay, the small particles, the fine particles will be collected in the this classifier. Okay, in the machinery. Now listen very carefully how this machinery works. What happens? The solid material is introduced through this inlet. Okay, and with that solid material there is a flow or blow of high speed air. Okay, now what happens? That high speed air takes the solid material inside the tube. Okay, the passage of the our fluid energy mill. What happens? That solid material keeps on rotating inside the this tube, and again there will be a centrifugal force. The heavy particles will move towards the outer surface and the light particle or the small particles will move inside of the or inside layer of the this fluid energy mill. Now the large size particles will move along the surface and the small size particles will move along the inside surface of the fluid energy mill, and ultimately what will happen, the small size particle will fall inside the classifier. Okay, and these will be collected and will be removed from the machine for further utilization in the pharmaceutical manufacturing. And the large size particle will again keep on moving inside the machinery until and unless they become small and fall inside the classifier. Okay, the small particles are collected in the classifier. The larger particle will have attrition and the impact principles, due to which they will be reduced in size, and the reduced size particles will fall inside the classifier. This is a very simple working of the machinery. You are required to learn the large size particle will move along the outside surface and the small particles will move along the inside surface, and this happens due to the centrifugation or centrifugal force. Okay, I will also forward the PPT in the description link. Okay, you can also go through these para for better understanding. If you feel or you have any question regarding the working of this fluid energy mill, you can definitely ask in the comment box. I will try to answer instantly. Okay, now moving further, the uses. The advantage of the fluid energy mill is the thermolabile materials can be processed very easily inside the fluid energy mill. Okay, and for that antibiotics and vitamins are the major products that are processed, okay, reduced inside in the fluid energy mill. Okay, now moving further, the advantage and the disadvantage of the fluid energy mill. Okay, the very important advantage of the fluid energy mill is the heat labile substances or the thermolabile substances can be easily processed in the fluid energy mill, like sulfonamides, vitamins and our antibiotics. Okay, the next is, it in the fluid energy mill, the processing of size reduction is very fast and the very efficient. And the third is, there are no moving parts in the machinery, due to which the maintenance of the machine is very easy, and there are very less or no chances of contamination during the process of size reduction, as there is no moving part inside the our fluid energy mill. Now when we talk about the disadvantage, the major disadvantage of the fluid energy mill is, this mill is not suitable for soft and fibrous material. Okay, means we cannot reduce the size very easily of the soft and the fibrous material. The solid materials can be reduced very easily in size in the fluid energy mill. Okay, this was all about the fluid energy mill. Again, this is Rohit Kumar Trivedi. I will be teaching you pharmaceutical engineering. You can go through my previous lectures too and stay updated. You can follow me on YouTube, subscribe and hit the bell icon. You will get all the notification instantly. Again, in future I will try to start the GPET classes also. Okay, and you can also find me on Facebook. There is a Facebook page with the name Rohit Kumar Trivedi. You can also like, share and subscribe that page also for the latest pharmacy information. Till then, happy learning. Goodbye.